everyone, and welcome to another episode of Ask an Author. Today I'm joined by Kester Fleming. Welcome, Kester.
Hi, thanks very much for having me, Michelle.
Oh, I'm so excited to talk about your new book. But before we do that, I wanted to ask you, have you always been a great reader and writer? What was your relationship with books when you were little?
Ah, that's a good question. I actually loved books and stories growing up. So once I could read, which seemed to take too long from my memory of that whole process, once I was able to read, I took off and read everything I could lay my hands on. But I actually grew up in a family where my dad read to us at the dinner table every night. So he used to get, my mum always used to excuse him and say, you know, you don't normally read at the table, but he gets indigestion. So this slows him down. So, as long as I can remember, meals at home involved a story. And they might be a story that's gone on for like a series of weeks. And it went from my earliest memories right through to me leaving home. So yeah, story, I've always been surrounded by stories.
Oh, I love that. That's almost like the start of a story in itself. I love that. So where do you get the ideas for your stories?
Now, I find that question quite a challenge, Michelle. Partly because I don't know sometimes, like, or I feel a little bit of a fraud perhaps sometimes, because when I hear other authors answer that question, they say things like, oh, ideas are all around you and that sort of thing. And sometimes, to be honest, I feel devoid of ideas, and I think to myself, where do other people get ideas from? But so for me, they come in fits and spurts, I guess. So sometimes I've got loads of inspiration, and other times I have these really dry patches and I get totally frustrated. So I live down in Melbourne and we're in lockdown at the moment, and lockdown I do not find inspiring. So I know other authors have churned out a whole heap of stuff, but for me, it's like, oh, you know, reflecting on why can I not find anything to write about? And I think, well, towards the end of last year, when we'd just gone through that really long lockdown period, I was fed up with myself and the lack of ideas. So I signed up to do yet another writer's course. And it's not like I haven't done, you know, multiple, but and it wasn't like I even needed the advice so much. I like being set something to do. So if there's any kids watching this, I would say, value what your teachers give you. I go searching for that sometimes. You know, when a teacher sets you a creative writing topic and you get that, that's something as simple as that is a springboard for me. So doing this writing course at the end of last year, I had heaps of ideas and loads of stories that came out of it. So that, just something as simple as that for me helps. But the other, you know, other times, I guess, that I'm most inspired is conversations with people, meet new stuff. So going out, and I guess that's why lockdown was not that inspiring for me. Yeah, being able to see new things, do new things, talk to new people, just hearing other people's stories.
Yep, totally understand. I know we haven't had anywhere near the experience that you guys have had down in Melbourne, but I know during the time last year that Brisbane was in lockdown, I could not write a thing. I couldn't. There was nothing, just creatively, I just felt so drained and so empty. So absolutely, I totally understand that. And one of the things I tell kids too, that if they're stuck for an idea, is to read. Do you read a lot now in the genres that you're writing in?
I do read quite a bit. I'm really lucky. I belong to a book club for lovers of children's literature. So every month we do a picture book, a chapter book, and a YA, young adult. And it's great because, you know, the books that we read are not necessarily books that I would pick up myself.
Yeah.
But we always have great discussions. And I guess that's another place you get ideas, just by talking to other like-minded people and talking about stories and so on. So yeah, I definitely read.
Absolutely. So, but tell me about this new book that's coming out, this amazing series. Where did you get the idea for this one?
So the idea for, so there's two in the series so far. So there's Marlo Brown Scientist in the Making, which came out in 2019, and then the new one is Magician in the Making.
Yes.
So the idea for the first one came from doing a writing course with Cheryl Clark. So I'm true to my word, that's where I get my ideas from often.
Yeah.
In fact, I think from that particular course with Cheryl, I sold, I don't know, maybe 4 or 5 stories or plays and so on to School Magazine. So yeah, I really do find courses a rich source of ideas. So yeah, that's where the idea for this one came from. I had Cheryl's task was write about your character's last birthday in first person. And that was the springboard. And that chapter in this book is not the start, it's the middle. So I then went back and found the rest of the story after having written about this birthday party. Whereas the second one was an entirely different kettle of fish. That one I was thinking, well, it's a series and it's about Marlo Brown and I want it to flow on from the last one, but be a story in itself that can stand alone. So I wanted to springboard it from the last story. So I was thinking, okay, so where did we end up? We ended up with this science experiment that could have gone massively wrong or right, and that's where it's left. So it's gone massively right for her. And so she's at the royal show, and her dad is showing these ginormous vegetables that he's grown as a result of her science experiment. So then she meets this magician while she's at the show. So that was the lead in for that.
Oh, that's amazing. So will there be more?
Hopefully, yes. I'm working on number 3 at the moment. But as I said, you know, that was my task for last year. And I'm still writing it because I wasn't inspired enough. So, but I'm working on it and it's coming together slowly but surely.
One word at a time, isn't it?
That's right.
So what's the best bit about what you do? What do you really, really love?
I love playing with words. I just love working with words and getting to play around with them. So that... but perhaps the best bit is once you've been playing around with them is the new creation, like having that new creation, the new story. I love that. And I can go back and reread it countless times just because I'm feeling so proud of myself for having finished. And it's not to say that there's not more work after that to, you know, finesse it and so on. But yeah, I think that's my high point, having got it down on the page and there's my little baby, my new creation. And I was thinking, yeah, the other best bit is having it published and having readers read it. But actually, that's not the best bit. That's icing on the cake. So the best, obviously you want readers as a writer, but having it published doesn't necessarily, well, you know, you might get readers even if it's not published. So if you belong to writers groups and that sort of thing. So, yeah.
I love that. So... I mean, there's a lot of writers out there who I guess can preach that it comes so easily to them. But for those of us, me included, who sometimes do struggle to get those words out of our head and onto page and find those new, exciting, creative ideas, what would be your advice to those aspiring authors?
I would say join a writers group. Or create one if you haven't got one that you can join. That's what I did for. Have a writers group where you've got like-minded writers. And then even if you don't have something to share every month or however often you meet, just talking to other people who write and enjoying their stories will help you. And then joining things like Squibby, going to conferences where you hear authors and publishers and illustrators talking, I find that really inspiring, and I think it's a great source of inspiration. You can go away from those events feeling really ready to write your next thing. So yeah, I think that's what I would most recommend.
Beautiful. And for those people also who want to get a copy of this series, where would be the best place that they could go?
Well, it's available. You can, yeah, it's available online from all the online bookstores. But you can also ask for it at your local bookshop. They should be able to get it in, or your library. Yeah.
Perfect. Yeah. And if people want to contact you and find out a little bit more about what you do, where would be the best place that they could contact you?
If they go to my website, which is literally kesterfleming.com, basically.
Perfect. I can put all of those links in the comments as well, so that if anybody wants to get a copy of the latest release or contact Kester, then absolutely you can do that. Thank you so much. I've had such a great time talking to you today and finding out we have got things in common. I think that's also a great part of talking to like-minded people, that I think we realize we have more in common than not.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And yeah, such a source of inspiration and ideas just to talk to others.
Absolutely. Good luck during lockdown. We'll be thinking of you. And yes, I can't wait for the next book.
Oh, thank you very much, Michelle. Thank you so much for the opportunity to have a chat with you. I've really enjoyed it.
Me too. Bye.
Bye.